Good morning. Welcome to Old St. Mary's Church as we gather to celebrate the Eucharist on this, the 18th Sunday in Ordinary Time. I'm Carl Bernardo, and Scott and I will lead the music. Please silence all electronic devices, and let's stand and take a moment to safely greet one another. How do you do? All of the readings for this Mass can be found on page 1247 in your hymnal, and the music and readings can be found in this week's worship aid. Feel free to follow along on your phone or device if you'd like on the OSM Parish app, or click the Sunday worship aid link on the front page of our parish website, oldstmarys.com. Presiding at liturgy and preaching is Father Schoeberle. Our gathering song is number 683, Abundant Life, number 683.
Sky, the moon, the wildflowers growing, for we are part of all that is within life's river flowing. With open hands receive and share the gifts of God's creation. Bodies shiver in the night, and weary wait for morning, when children have no bread but tears, and war horn sounds their warning. God calls humanity to wait, to join in humanity to join as partners in creating a future free from want or fear, life's goodness celebrating. That new world's beckoned from afar invites our shared endeavor, that all may have abundant life and peace endure forever.
The name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
This morning we are asked a simple question in the scriptures. Do we understand the graces given to us, and will we share the abundance we have received? As we puzzle over that question, let us ask for God's guiding mercy in our lives.
Lord Jesus, you came to show us the way. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to reveal the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came that we might have life to the full. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Let us pray. O Lord, draw near to your servants and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. Vanity of vanities, says Qoheleth, vanity of vanities, all things are vanity. Here is one who has labored with wisdom and knowledge and skill, and yet to another who has not labored over it, he must leave property. This also is vanity, and a great misfortune. For what profit comes to man from all the toil and anxiety of heart with which he has labored under the sun? All his days sorrow and grief is his occupation. Even at night, his mind is not at rest. This also is vanity. The word of the Lord.
and say, Return, O children of men, to your eyes a thousand years are like yesterday come and gone, or like a watch in the night. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. You sweep them away like a dream, like grass that springs up in the morning. In the morning it sprouts and is fresh. By evening it withers and fades. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. Then teach us to number our days, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Turn back, O Lord, how long? Show pity to your servants. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. At dawn, fill us with your merciful love. We shall exult and rejoice all our days. Let the favor of the Lord our God be upon us. Give success to the work of our hands. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ your life appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. Put to death, then, the parts of you that are earthly: immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire, and the greed that is idolatry. Stop lying to one another, since you have taken off the old self with its practices and have put on the new self, which is being renewed for knowledge in the image of its Creator. Here there is not Greek and Jew, circumcision and uncircumcision, barbarian, Scythian, slave, free, but Christ is all and in all. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
name. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to share the inheritance with me." He replied to him, "Friend, who appointed me as your judge and arbitrator?" Then he said to the crowd, "Take care to guard against all greed, for though one may be rich, one's life does not consist of possessions." And then he told them a parable. There was a rich man whose land produced a bountiful harvest, and he asked himself, "What shall I do? For I do not have enough space to store my harvest." Then he said, "This is what I shall do. I shall tear down my barns and build larger ones. There I shall store all my grain and other goods, and I shall say to myself, 'Now as for you, you have so many good things stored up for many years. Rest, eat, drink, and be merry.'" But God said to him, "You fool! This night your life will be demanded of you, and the things that you have prepared, to whom will they belong? Thus will it be for all who store up treasure for themselves, but are not rich in what matters to God." The Gospel of the Lord. All right, repeat after me. Mine, mine, all mine.
Mine, mine.
I think you can do that better. Mine, mine.
All mine.
Okay. What celebrity said that? No hands? It's going to seem so obvious when I say it. Daffy Duck. Okay. And you can look that up. Huh? You can look up the clip on YouTube. The whole clip is Bugs Bunny is trying to get to Pismo Beach, of course. And we see the burrow and his head pop up through it. He's in a cave. And he says, "I knew I should have made a left at Albuquerque." Now, Daffy is crawling over him because he's been underground, a very undignified way for a duck to travel. And he notices they have come up in this cave where there's the stash of gold and gold coins. And he jumps on top of Bugs to drive him back into the ground with the words, "Mine, mine, all mine." And certainly, the approach to riches in the scriptures today is to say this type of understanding of possessions is not what God wants. This miserliness smacks of hoarding and withholding from others. When someone has been given much, they are invited to share it. It's interesting that if you look at the portrayals of large stashes of treasures, like cash, coin, precious metals, jewels, and other objects, you ever notice that they're always very clean? In Daffy, they are in a cave. In Daffy, they are in our cave. Or if you look at the caves of the riches in The Lord of the Rings, you'll see the treasures of the dragon Smaug, as in The Hobbit. And even the caves of Gringotts from Harry Potter. And do you see anything that looks like cobwebs or dust or dirt covering any of those? Even when we see vaults in shows, who cleans them? There must be pretty good security clearance and background checks, to keep things looking so spick and span. And how many of us, after dusting or sweeping around the house, can go very long without noticing there's more dust and there's more dirt to replace what we've cleaned up? Certainly, if you have this stash of riches, as in the story today, you must constantly care for it. It demands your attention to keep it in good order, or it is going to stack up with dirt and things are going to get hidden underneath it all. If any of you have ever seen one of those hoarder shows, there's one particular one I saw where the lady is a collector of Barbies, and she has filled her house, the closets and all the rooms, including the rooms of her sons and husband, with Barbies. That was, of course, not as bad as the house where the food stuff was among what was piling up. Chicken is made to be eaten quickly, and after a few days, well, I'll stop there. You get where that's going. Hoarding things piles up on you, and that can take over your life. Now, I say that whether it's a good thing or a bad thing. There's lots of stuff that can take things over if you just want to keep it and hold on to it. But the message of the gospel is, I have given you an abundance of things, and you have to see the other part of abundance are the people around you that you are asked to share with. Another couple celebrities, maybe you've heard of them, Barbara Streisand or Carol Channing, will remind you of a certain musical. Hello, Dolly. Yes, Hello, Dolly. Another character in that show is Horace Vandergelder, and he's a wealthy merchant in Yonkers, and Dolly wants him as the future Mr. Dolly Levi. Dolly says to him about money, and this is in my bulletin article this week as well, money is like manure. It's no good unless you spread it around. It is a message Jesus would concur with. It is part of our gospel today, and it doesn't just apply to money. It applies to goods. It applies to talents. It applies to time, all of that. Wealth has one main purpose, to make people's lives better. And not just the person who has it, but the people that can be helped by it. And there are many types of wealth and riches that we are all called to recognize and share. Each of us have been given something. Now, did I mention yet that I played the lottery on Friday? Yep, the Mega Millions, and I won. $4. I think someone did get the 1. Whatever billion here in the Illinois area. But with that prize, you know, it draws your mind to, well, what am I going to do? Well, if I got that, what would I do? Now, I'm used to having people come up to me who have purchased lottery tickets and said, Father, would you pray for me that I can win? No surprise there. And then you know what the other line is they always add on. And when I win, I will give something to the church. And I usually don't say this directly to them, but my usual response would be, well, you know, if you just put $5 in the collection basket every week, I'd be totally fine with that. and that's the thing about when we have an abundance, what we're willing to share, the ability to give even a little bit is a very great reminder of how we are called to share God's gifts with us. So as I said, I won $4. It's all going to the church. Okay, and it will. A few months ago, I was reading a book, The Book of Joy, by the Dalai Lama and by Archbishop Desmond Tutu. And one of the chapters within the book is actually talking about the gift of generosity and how generosity enables people to live healthier lives, to be better people. And interesting that when you watch these two characters, and there are videos on this book of the interviews and all that, and when you look at these two men looking at each other, there is a sparkle in their eye. There is a joy in their cadence. They're constantly razzing each other. You know, if you were Buddha, if you were Buddhist, you would be much better. And if you were Christian, you would be much, and they go back and forth. But in both of those, what you understand is there is great respect and love between those two men, and more so an understanding of the spiritual principles that occupy this planet in every spiritual world. So when they're talking about generosity and the gift of generosity, the generosity to be able to share a smile, the generosity to see someone who is alone that might need someone to walk with them, the generosity of stopping to help someone in need, those are all things that they draw our attention to, and they go further by talking about the scientific studies that have been done with all of those. And so if you follow up with Daffy Duck, and then you go to the Dalai Lama and Archbishop Tutu, and then you follow up with some TED Talks, you will find out that one of the chemicals that is involved in our brain is one called oxytocin. And oxytocin, when it clicks in, and it clicks in for the giver, when someone decides to give something, whatever that may be, and when they give it to someone especially in need, the oxytocin doesn't just affect their brain, it affects the brain of the person receiving it. It is a gift that keeps on giving it. And if that wasn't enough, as science continues to look at it, it isn't just the giver, it isn't just the receiver, it is also the watcher. People who see other people give themselves have this boost of oxytocin, which of course suppresses cortisol and overcomes depression. One of the talkers in the TED Talk was talking about her grandchildren and how much when children are taught to give and to share, that they become happier. They grow in awareness of their own self-esteem. And that self-esteem helps to keep them away from being depressed or being weighed down. They find that they are kinder, and the people around them discover more kindness. Seniors discover more meaning in their lives because generosity is contagious. It's time to start that kind of an epidemic, I think, is what Jesus would say. The generosity that is contagious takes us into our heart, makes us realize what we've been given, and in the sharing with others, there is joy that they now have more, and there is this joy that redounds and rebounds back to us. So we spend money on others and ourselves, and it becomes contagious. Mine, all mine, can be flipped to say, yours, all yours. And in realizing that when Jesus gives us his body and blood, his life to be shared, there was a generosity of love and wisdom that the world has never seen. So his mine is ours. And we share with each other, and the more we share, the more it comes back. May we be open to God's generosity to us by being generous to one another, and there discover our joy. Let us together profess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. With generous hearts, let us raise our voices, praying for the needs of all.
That we, the Church, will strive to keep the Lord's teaching against the hoarding of wealth and set an example of stewardship and generosity, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have been blessed with an abundance of material goods will be moved to share with those who lack even the basic needs of life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have suffered the devastating effects of flooding and fire, and for the safety of all who have come to their aid, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant healing of the spiritual, cultural, and physical wounds inflicted by so many Christians on the indigenous people of the world. Help us to remember and to never repeat the sins of the past, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring an end to the crime and violence that is present in the streets of our city and nation, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who suffer chronic illness will be comforted by the caring presence of their family, friends, and caregivers, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the dead will receive the eternal treasure of everlasting life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of Anne Burian and all the intentions we hold in prayerful silence. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also are conscious of the generosity of so many people who join us online each week. Let us pause and consider the prayers that they may be offering in their home. For those prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, giver of every good gift, keep our eyes fixed on our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. And of course, thank you for your generous giving to the parish, especially during this time of COVID. Generosity makes a big difference. Thanks, too, to those who contribute online by mailing in their contributions or using the Give button at the parish website. May you be blessed and see that come back to you many times over.
Our presentation of Gifts Hymn is number 865, We Belong to You, number 865.
We belong to you, O Lord, our longing. We belong to you. In our daily living, dying and rising, we belong to you. In the waters of your mercy, when the old becomes anew, souls united in the mystery, we belong to you. We belong to you, O Lord of our longing. We belong to you. In our daily gifts and filled with goodness, Spirit breathing life into all who seek to find their purpose, we belong to you. share bread you've broken with the many and the few. We are blessed and we are broken. We belong to you. We belong to you, O Lord of our longing. We belong to you. In our daily living, dying and rising, we belong to you. We belong to you. We belong to you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice.
O Lord, graciously accept and sanctify these gifts, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And with your heart.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you
for the forgiveness of sins.
Do this in memory of me." mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross, to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people that you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God and our patron, with Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Ignatius, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. To say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room.
Our communion hymn is number 1046, From the Many Make Us One, number 1046. Jesus prayed before he died, to this table now we come, make them one, this whole world wide, from the many make us one. Every shade and tribe and tongue, to this table now we come, male and female, old and young. When we sing and when we cry, as we live and as we die, to this table now we come, from the many make us one. Jesus washed their feet and cried, to this table now we come, grieve the deeds that would divide, from the many make us one. Bow us down now each to all, to this table now we come, make this world a banquet hall, from the many make us one. When we sing and when we cry, as we live and as we die, to this table now we come, from the many make us one. Love the world so loved by God, to this table now we come, tattered, scattered, worn and trod, from the many make us one. Come to welcome table here, to this table now we come, doors wide open, nothing fear, from the many make us one. When we sing and when we cry, as we live and as we die, to this table now we come, from the many make us one.
Let us pray. O Lord, accompany with constant care those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you once again for joining us in prayer and worship, especially those joining us online, as well as those present here in person. Let's continue to pray for and care for each other. Some of the stuff that the parish is in need of these days. Registration is open for Sunday's fall faith formation classes, and there's also a need for catechists. If you want to sign up or if you want to become one of our catechists, that would be greatly appreciated. There is a blood drive here next Sunday from 9 to 3 p.m. See the bulletin for information about making an appointment or to donate much-needed blood. There's also information on the Mass that Archbishop Supich celebrates for those celebrating 50 years of marriage together. You can find all of that in our parish bulletin, which is available on the tables. You can also get all that information on the bulletin at the parish website, oldstmarys.com, as well as the parish app, which will give you all of that as well, and so much more, and all the Mass connections and all that. Are there any newcomers or visitors with us for the first time today? If you want to wave your hands. How many are here for Lollapalooza? Not so many. Okay. Hope you guys have a great day. Come back. Join us anytime. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Go in peace and generously share the love of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Our recessional hymn is number 755. There's a wideness in God's mercy, number 755.
Why will